If you haven't imported your media onto your timeline yet, or you don't know how to, simply click File on the top left menu bar here, and then come down to Import and select Media. Alternatively, you can press Ctrl plus I if you're on PC, or Command plus I if you're on Mac, and this will bring up the same window to search for your footage. Navigate to where you've saved your video you'd like to use, and double click or select Open, which will place it onto the media pool, as you can see here. Next, you'll want to click and drag your media onto video track 1 on your timeline, like so. If you don't want the audio from your footage, just select it and press the backspace key, which will remove it from the timeline. To make the process easier, we can expand the timeline a bit so that we can be more precise by clicking the zoom in button here, which makes it easier to select certain frames. Next, you'll want to go ahead and select the blade tool here, or press B for the shortcut until it highlights red. Then find the area you'd like the freeze frame to start from by dragging the playhead across while looking at your preview screen above. Once you've found it, click on the video and you'll notice it created a cut. In this case, we'll want the playhead to move for just one frame, so we'll zoom in again and then press the right arrow on your keyboard once to skip one frame only. Making sure the blade tool is still selected, click on the video where the playhead is now placed to make another cut just like this. You'll now have two cuts, and essentially this has split the video into three parts. You can think of it as the intro, the freeze frame, and the outro if you like. Make sure we're on the select tool now by clicking the arrow here or pressing A for the shortcut, and then you'll want to right click on the middle part of the video and select change clip speed. From here, you'll see a number of options pop up, but we just want to go ahead and select freeze frame and then click change. At the moment, the freeze frame is only visible for one frame, so if you play it back, you'll notice it skipped right past the freeze frame so quickly that it seems like the video just kept playing. To change this, we just need to expand the length of the freeze frame by first zooming out a slight bit, and then dragging the last section of our video to the right a touch, like so, which creates this gap between the footage. Now, hover over the right side of the freeze frame until you see this symbol, and then click and drag until you connect it with the third clip again. You'll notice that once you get close to the third clip, it will automatically click into place, which is great. As you can see when we play the video back now, it creates this cool freeze frame effect, which adds a nice visual to your footage. If you found this video helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel, where I'll be uploading more helpful tips and tutorials on DaVinci Resolve. Until the next time, thanks for watching.